In this tutorial, we're gonna show you how to organize your products and how to create collections inside Shopify. Let's get into it. Hey guys, welcome to another Shopify tutorial. If you have watched our tutorials in the past, you probably own a business or in the process of building a Shopify store. And if you decide that you would like to take your store off your hands and focus more on the business, then you need to check out our Sales Accelerator Program. This program uses online advertising to increase your sales on your website. And as always, if you aren't already subscribed, make sure that you hit that subscribe button and that bell notification so you know when we drop more tutorials. Let's get into it. So the first thing you want to do is basically think about your store and think about how you want to sort of categorize some of your products. So right now we have a drop-down menu from one of our previous episodes that we did where we identified that we wanted to do bones and bow ties. Depending on the type of products that you have, this will probably change. You may have, let's say, a clothing store where you want to categorize them by maybe men's, women's clothing, maybe winter, summer collections. So there's a lot of different things that you can do as far as organizing your products. So that's something that you would have to think about. Also look into the competition, see how they are organizing their products, see how many navigation items they have at the top. And once you determine that you want to do, let's say, men's, women's, and then you also want to do shirts, pants, skirts, and things like that, then you want to go to your products tab over here on Shopify. And then the all products is just going to show you your list of products, but you want to go to collections. And then in collections, I already have a few collections set up, but let's just create a new one. So we're going to hit create a new collection. And in here, you want to give the collection a title. This title will be displayed typically on the header of that particular page. So you want to do something that, you know, it's going to be nice to look at, not something that it's more of an internal title. So for example, let's say that we want to create a flash sale collection. We want to call it flash sale. You can add a description, which is optional. You could also add a collection image, which is optional. This collection image will show on that page. They're typically long horizontal images. So just kind of be careful. You can add them and then see how it looks on the website and gauge on how, you know, you want to display it or not display it at all. In this instance, we're not going to do any collection images. And then the next thing here is the collection type. So you have two options. You can do manual or automated. For manual, you actually have to go in and hand pick certain products. So in this particular instance where we're doing a flash sale collection, this might make sense for us. So we might just click manual. And we're able to sort of handpick some of those products that will be in that flash sale collection. I'm gonna go ahead and hit save on that. And once you hit save, then it gives you the ability to search for those products. So if I'm searching for, let's say just bone, I don't have many products in here, but let's say just dry bones and pumpkin bones are the only ones that are on this flash sale collection. We're going to add those in here and you see they're displayed right there. You also have the ability to change the display order. So if you're going to do highest price, lowest price, newest, oldest, you can even do it manually, where you can kind of click and drag on the order of these products. That's about it on creating these manual products. I'm going to go ahead and create another collection. And let's say that you have, just like the example says here, maybe a summer collection. Right, so let's call it summer collection. So when you click on automated, it's going to give you different conditions. So for example, here we have all products must match all the conditions, or you can set it for any of these conditions. So let's say that you have a bunch of products already in your store and you're now getting into, oh, I need to actually figure out the collection stuff. So let's say that any condition, because the product, let's say the product tag equals to maybe summer. Let's say that some of the products you added the product tag summer. Now, it could be that some products you added the tag summer, but other products you had the product type as equal to summer. So in this instance, any condition would mean that, let's say you have a product that's tagged with summer, but then you have a product type equals to summer. both of those products will show up in this collection. If you would get, if you click on all conditions, that means that the product has to have the tag of summer and it has to have the product type of summer, which we don't want. We're gonna do any condition in this instance. And that's basically it. That means that anytime that a product has tag, the product tag summer or the product type summer, it will be added automatically to the summer collection. There's a lot of different things that you can do with these, with the conditions. You can also do by product title, product type, vendor, price, compare at price, weight, inventory, variance, title. So there's a lot of different things. Something else that you can do, if you already type in into your product, product title. So for example, we do product title contains the word summer. Maybe you've organized your product in that manner, then this will give you the, that flexibility of if the product title contains the word summer in it, then it will get automatically added to this particular collection. And then we can just click save on that and that's it. Now, these collections are sort of internal collections right now because we haven't added them to the navigation. In a previous episode, we actually talked a little bit about that, but in order to put these collections into the store navigation, you wanna go to online store, then navigation, and then you wanna find your menu. And then in this instance, we have the menu catalog, and then in here we have these. So we wanna add a menu item here, and we wanna type in summer. And then in the link, you can either search or navigate through this in order to find it. So we can go to collections, and then we'll see the summer collection right there. And then we can go ahead and click add, and then save the menu. And that means that when we refresh this page, and we hover over or click on catalog, we'll see our summer collection, which we don't have any products that match those conditions. So it's gonna say, sorry, there are no products in this collection. But if you set this up correctly, you will see your products populate in here within the collection page. Okay, that's it. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. If you find this video helpful, make sure that you hit that like button. And if you wanna see other Shopify tutorials, make sure that you subscribe to our YouTube channel. That will help us tremendously. And if you click the bell notification, you will get notified anytime that we drop a new Shopify tutorial.